Hello flyers and welcome back to the channel. Here we have a list of current receivers that can be updated to AS3X Plus. I have a DX8 Gen 2 transmitter, so I'll be using the programming cable. Some of the newer transmitters may be able to update without the cable. You will need this, and it is available on the Spektrum website. This is what it looks like. You're going to need ready access to the receiver. You may need to unglue it if it's not accessible. You will need to plug in the other end of the programming cable into the programming port on the receiver. The next step would be to fire up the program on your desktop or laptop and then plug in the USB into the USB port. You'll see it says cable connected but no device. So we're going to need to power up the device to make it accessible. But the first step is to turn on your transmitter, make sure it's powered up to the model that you do plan on updating. The next step is to power the device. So you're going to do this either by clicking on the little button that says power from the computer, or you're going to hook up your flight pack. Don't do both or you will smoke the receiver. This window will pop up next. Just say use device settings for the time being. It really doesn't matter. Once you're connected, the program will look for available updates. You're going to want to choose that option that says install another version. You're going to want to choose the top option that says convert from V2 to V3. Note that once you do this, there's no going back, as Spektrum has said. This conversion takes a few seconds, so be patient. Once that's done, you need to go back into the forward programming functions and scroll down and choose the factory reset option. This resets the receiver and it will recognize the new AS3X functionality. Once that's completed, to the transmitter, this is a brand new receiver that it's never seen before, so you need to go back into the programming functions and do a bind to bind your receiver again to the transmitter. At this point, you're going to need to do several first-time setup features and functions as if you're getting this receiver for the first time. That includes the safe select features and a few others. In my receiver, I have a three-position switch for the gyro, which is off, regular AS3X, and safe. That will need to be programmed in again as far as what channels you're assigning to the flight modes, and what channel is going to be the gains, etc. Here I'm teaching the transmitter the orientation of the receiver. In the following steps, I'm setting up my flight modes with respect to whether I want the gyro on, off, or safe, and also the AS3X gains. For my safe flight mode, I like to have as much control as possible. It lets you adjust the bank angle limits. Typically in a bind and fly that has safe, you can't adjust these. At least that was the old school way. Now you can at least give yourself roll authority up to 90% and pitch authority up to 75%. One way to know if this update has been successful is to go into the function list and see if you have the nose steering gyro feature. Another cool feature is the ability to test the gyro correction. If you go into System Setup in the Utilities menu, you'll be able to click on Gyro Response Tests. This exaggerates the gyro response when you're moving the surfaces to let you know that you're correcting in the right direction. Finally, if you go back into the programming app on your desktop, if you click on Edit for the model that you just updated, you can actually type in the nickname for it, which is typically the type of plane or the name of the plane that it's in there. And you can put in AS3X Plus, or in my case, I'm putting L39 64mm, and you'll see that it does say version 3. Okay, flyers, that's it for today. If you found this useful, it would help me if you liked and subscribed. But have fun flying.